Welcome to the Philippine Motor Show. This is Autofocus. I'm Ray Louis Gamboa. Here's a menu of some of our features on this edition of your electronic magazine, exclusive to the automobile and its industry.
Starting off with reviews of two vehicle models presently in the local market, a pickup from SsangYong, the 2019 Musso 2.2L 4x2 AT, and another pickup this time from Mitsubishi, the 2019 Strada GT 4-wheel drive AT. We'll also have a glimpse of some of the latest automobile models and concept cars from around the world. This week, we have the 2019 Fiat 500 Dolce Vita Edition and the 2020 Mercedes-Benz AMG CLA 45. Plus, a feature-to-feature comparison of two subcompact SUVs, the 2019 Kia Sportage and the 2019 MG ZS, together with the latest news and developments in the local auto industry. We shall have the recently held launch of the new Honda BRV on our special feature.
The next 60 minutes is all about the automobile. This is Autofocus, and we'll be right back after this short break.
To expect high performance from Phoenix Fuels.
We made it!
Now with Pulse Technology, delivers enhanced power and acceleration to make every trip come alive. Every time I'm on the road, I can also expect high performance from Phoenix Fuels.
We made it!
Now with Pulse Technology, delivers enhanced power and acceleration to make every trip come alive.
Suzuki, all new Eltiga.
Life is beating fast. Find what you're waiting for.
Seven-seater in style. All new Eltiga debut.
Part of the 2019-2020 Autofocus People's Choice Awards, only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on to www.autofocus.com.ph/AFPCA2019. Then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2019-2020 Autofocus Automobile of the Year in separate standard and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until September 30, 2019. The Autofocus People's Choice Awards will win. You choose, you decide. Vote now.
Welcome back to Autofocus, the automobile show. We start this edition of your electronic magazine with a review of one of the latest automobile models from SsangYong. What we have in this edition of Car Review is an offering from SsangYong that possesses most of the things that you would look for in a pickup. From its design down to the smallest details, the 2019 Musso no doubt comes strong with its own identity. Find out more about it here. Watch this.
In this car review, we have the 2019 SsangYong Musso 2.2-liter 4x2 AT. Under the hood of the Musso is a powerful 2.2-liter turbocharged diesel engine that delivers 179 horsepower and 420 Nm of torque. These figures are mated to a 6-speed automatic transmission that transfers all power to two wheels. All Musso variants are 4x2 and come with an automatic transmission, except for the two Musso Grand variants that come in 4x4 and a manual transmission respectively. The Musso also offers various driving modes which a driver can choose from depending on the road condition that the pickup will be taking on. Meanwhile, handling is managed by a coil spring at the rear suspension. For a pickup, this setup is uncommon, although the Musa is not one to miss road imperfections as you could feel a little roughness here and there. Basing on the exterior of the Musa, there's no doubt that this pickup showcases a masculine design. Up front, the radiator grille highlights the front fascia of the Musa, more so the halogen headlamps with daytime running lights. Character lights are also present, especially just below the belt line. This gives the Musa's body more definition. The Musa's side mirrors are power folding and adjustable with LED turn signal integrated. Over at the rear, the taillights are bigger than those of Musa's predecessors, though the change is not that visible. Also, the cargo bed may be shorter than the previous ones, but it's deeper and wider and could carry more baggage. The Musa powers through the road with 18-inch alloy wheels, adding extra character to the pickup. Let's hop on in our featured vehicle. The interior of the Musa could compete as one of the best in the market, and it's because the Korean car maker put the drivers and passengers' comfort and convenience first before anything else. For one, the cabin is spacious and is not cluttered at all. The buttons and controls are in the right places and within reach of the driver. The speed-sensing power steering wheel comes with a heater, which makes up for the fact that it comes with tilt configuration only. But the real show stealer here is the seats, wrapped in a premium brown Nappa leather. The driver's seat is heated and ventilated, and is 8-way power adjustable. Meanwhile, the rear seats come with the seat heaters as well. For added convenience, the Musa is equipped with dual-zone auto climate control with rear vents. Plus, the window on the driver's side comes with one-touchdown option, among other interior features of the Musa. The infotainment system of the Musa comes with an 8-inch LCD smart audio with USB Apple CarPlay and Android Auto navigation. The 6 speakers handle the enjoyment while traveling. When it comes to safety and security, the Musa is equipped with features such as anti-lock braking system with electronic brake force distribution, remote keyless entry, rear view camera, and 6 airbags.
That was the 2019 SsangYong Musa, an offering from the Korean car maker that changes the game in the pickup segment. Our featured vehicle here on Car Review. The latest auto industry news and developments right after this break.
Motul is the most trusted motor oil of the top teams competing in some of the world's most grueling race competitions, the WRC, the WTCC, and the Japan GT. Motul is the only 100% fully synthetic motor oil in the market. It has antioxidation properties that prevent premature thickening and aging due to thermal stress and guarantees total engine protection. For more information about Motul engine oils, visit www.motul.com.ph or visit Autoplus Sports Zentrium located along EDSA, across White Plains.
Ah, the things that make my day. My mini-me. My kind of jam. My passion. My blend of coffee. My inspiration. That's all good. With the all-new Vios. My Vios. My drive.
Ako po si Michael Caliwag, 12 taon ng patrol crew para sa NLEX Esitex. Bilang patrol crew, handa akong marap sa anumang di nasaang sitwasyon. Naalala ko pa noon, 2009, Bagyong Ondoy. Papatrol kami sa NLEX nang may nakita kami isang pamilya na natrap sa bubong. Kahit kailangan magpatrol, nagdesisyon kami na sagapin at iligtas sila. Kami ang NLEX ACTEX Patrol Crew, kaagapay at katuwang nyo sa mas maayos na paglalakbay.
Welcome back to Auto Focus, and we now have the latest auto industry news.
Mazda Philippines has officially launched the new Mazda 6 range, the Mazda 6 Turbo Sedan, and the Mazda 6 Sports Wagon. The Mazda 6 Turbo Sedan is now equipped with Skyactiv G 2.5-liter turbocharged gasoline engine, which delivers a truly sublime experience behind the wheel. Meanwhile, the Mazda 6 Sports Wagon comes of age with a bold new look and a host of design and engineering improvements to enhance its stature. The new Mazda 6 range now spans three distinct models: the sedan 2.5-liter Skyactiv gasoline turbo, the sedan 2.2-liter Skyactiv diesel, and the Sports Wagon 2.5-liter Skyactiv gasoline.
Okay, what we've unveiled tonight is the new Mazda 6 Sports Wagon. Firstly, the new Mazda 6 Sports Wagon is the first time that we're bringing in this body type in the new face of the Mazda 6, which actually we've updated last year. So this new design of the Mazda 6 takes design cues from the Vision Coupe of Mazda. So it's now more elegant and more luxurious in terms of design and features. No? Now, what's even more exciting is actually the interior. We have Napa leather seats, chrome accents, suede accents as well, and wood. No? And we even have features now like Apple CarPlay and Android Auto Kit. We also have the lane keep assist, lane departure warning, blind spot monitoring, all safety features that actually you won't find in your normal medium-sized passenger car.
Aside from the unveiling of the latest additions to the new Mazda 6 range, Mazda Philippines also held a surprise reveal of the 30th anniversary edition of the Mazda MX-5. The limited edition model comes in an exclusive racing orange color and unique features and will only have 3,000 units worldwide, 30 of which will be made available for the Philippine market.
The MX-5 30th edition is actually a culmination of 30 years of Jin Baitai driving for the MX-5. So it puts in all these little elements that make driving all the more better for owners of the MX-5. So chief among the distinctive qualities of the MX-5 30th anniversary edition is the racing orange paint. So there will be an exclusive paint for 3,000 cars in the world, and this is it. And on the exterior, we have race engineering wheels, 17-inch, lightweight forged aluminum wheels. And then as you move inside under the hood, you have a 2-liter Skyactiv G engine with 184 PS of power. And it goes up to 7,500 RPM. So it's an upgrade from the first generation ND, the one that came out in 2015. So it's faster, it sounds better, and it rides really better all together.
The company also welcomed the new CX-9 ambassadors, including actor Mr. Johnny Revilla.
I've always said, the CX-9 is driving a European car without spending the money. It handles so well, it communicates with you as a driver. And because I like to drive, for me, I'm not much of a passenger guy, I like to drive. And of all the cars I've driven in this class, this one gives the most comfort. This one gives the most luxury. It's got all the dings and whistles and everything you want in a car. But yet, when you want the car to go like a sports car, although it's a crossover, a big crossover, it'll handle very well. If you want it to be comfortable in a boulevard and cruise, it's the perfect car.
UD Trucks and PrimeQuest Transport Solutions has officially launched the Kroner, an all-new medium-duty truck, to continue its rich Japanese legacy across Asia, Africa, Middle East, and South America.
UD Kroner is the medium-range truck, which is made by UD. For the first time in the Philippines, we are launching medium range truck.
Definitely, this truck is a big part of the cake, especially in Southeast Asia. The medium duty range is probably the most important segment in the Philippines. So for us, indeed, this is a very key segment. This is why we are pushing hard and strongly to introduce this vehicle in the Philippines with the support from Civic.
In addition to that, UD Croner is specifically designed for a growth market like the Philippines. It is introduced in the Middle East, in South America, in South Africa, as well as in other countries. So this is specifically designed for a growth market like the Philippines.
The Croner comes in two gross vehicle weight models, the LKE and PKE, on top of their wheelbase variants. These offer different basic configurations to suit specific demands of various industries. Additionally, the air suspension in all variants is available as an option to protect customers' cargo, especially when traveling on rough road conditions. The Croner's engine also utilizes the fuel needed efficiently without waste because of the new GHE engine series, automatic transmission, a built-in fuel coach, and a more aerodynamic cab.
The key features of the vehicle, it's important for you to know that UD Trucks is a company of the Volvo Group. So we are sharing the strengths between the Volvo Group, about the chassis, about the engines, about the frame, about the cabin. So basically, it's the mix of the Gemba spirit, Japanese heritage, utilization of the group strengths, as I mentioned, but also the local understanding of the ASEAN market and the growth market, as mentioned. So all three together, we are thinking that we have the right trucks and we have the right choice for the Filipino customer.
UD Trucks also offer extra mile support services, as well as professional telematics solution that provides customers with real-time information and reports beneficial for their fleet operation.
So basically, when the customers are testing and driving the vehicles there, they can also see after that the benefits of the UD telematics, which is 3 points. First is track and trace, second is a fuel consumption, and the last one is a fuel alert. So it's a simple tool. We can do that on your mobile phone. And it's a very simple and very useful tool, I think, for the Filipinos customer as well.
For more information about UD and our company, PrimeQuest Transport Solutions Incorporated, you can log on www.primequest.com.ph.
GAC Motor Philippines brought members of the local motor media to Guangzhou, China, to have a first-hand experience and tour of GAC Motor Company's two major plants in the area.
One is the new electric energy plant where they are producing the electric cars and hybrid. And the other is the regular plant where they do the combustible cars. Both of them are really state-of-the-art workshop and they are very impressed with what they have seen.
The group was able to see up close how the vehicle assembly area works. This is where the stamping, welding, painting, and general assembly take place. The welding area specifically covers an area of 24,000 square meters with an intended capacity of 150,000 units per year. It is divided by production process into the floor, sidewall, body, door, and assembly production areas. According to GAC, they're confident that the use of electric energy will benefit the Philippine market as it promotes green energy.
We believe that in Legado Motors that the electric energy is a very exciting product that which we should be bringing into the Philippines. As you can see, the whole world now has been quite conscious with green energy. And not only that, with the electric cars in the Philippines, we will be able to showcase that the green energy can be more efficient and can save our environment at the same time.
Isuzu Philippines joined the recent LTFRB Modern PUV Caravan. With the theme Modern PUV, Arangkada ng Pagbabago Tungo sa Kaunlaran, the program aims to promote the nationwide adoption of modernized public utility vehicles through the government's Public Utility Vehicle Modernization Program.
Today, Isuzu joined the LTFRB Modern PUV Caravan in 2019. This program aims to promote the nationwide adaptation of modernized public utility vehicles toward durable, comfortable, and safe transport solution to the riding public. We are very proud to be part of this event and showcase the brand new Isuzu QKR and NLR light-duty truck.
Isuzu brought in and showcased the brand new Isuzu QKR77, and NLR 77 light-duty trucks configured as modernized PUVs. Modernized PUVs from Isuzu are equipped with automatic fare collection system, a GPS tracking system, CCTV cameras and dash cams, and Wi-Fi router.
These PUVs are mounted on our very reliable Isuzu QKR and NLR light-duty truck platform, with body development by the country's leading bodybuilders, Almazora Motors Corporation and Central Manufacturing Corporation, and Santa Rosa Motor Works.
Apart from the Isuzu modern PUVs offering more legroom, headroom, and seat space for its passengers, the QKR and NLR platform assembled in the Philippines is equipped with the Euro 4 compliant 3.0-liter 4GH1TC CRDI diesel engine that delivers better fuel economy and cleaner emissions. Isuzu was also instrumental in helping the government kick off the PUVMP program in June 2018, when the Japanese truck manufacturer supplied the modern PUVs for the program's pilot operator, the Senate Employees Transport Service Cooperative.
The modern PUVs are designed to be very safe, convenient, comfortable, and very fuel efficient. So we are very happy as Isuzu to be part of this program. Today we started in Quezon Memorial Circle, and we participated in the motorcade that took us from Manila to SM Clark via the North Expressway.
The modern PUV caravan will be held in four phases, with each phase taking place in different parts of the country from July of this year until early 2020.
AutoFocus, the country's premier automobile news and features electronic magazine, takes another short break. Stay with us. I'll be right back.
The things that make my day. My mini-me. My kind of jam. My passion. My blend of coffee. My inspiration. That's all good. With the all-new Vios. My Vios. My drive.
Motoring Today is now on the web. Watch this episode or other past episodes of the country's longest-running motoring program any time of the day by logging on to our website, motoringtoday.ph. Motoring Today is now online, just a click away.
Suzuki, all new Eltiga.
Life is beating fast. Find what you're waiting for.
Seven-seater in style. All new Eltiga debut.
Be part of the 2019-2020 AutoFocus People's Choice Awards, the only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on to www.autofocus.com.ph/AFPCA2019. Then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2019-2020 AutoFocus Automobile of the Year in separate standard and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until September 30, 2019. The AutoFocus People's Choice Awards will win. You choose, you decide. Vote now.
Welcome back to this edition of AutoFocus, the country's premier automobile TV and online magazine. Here's Head to Head, our feature-to-feature comparison of the latest automobile models belonging to the same category. In this Head to Head, we will witness two cars that are fairly newcomers in the local market, yet considered as big competitors already. We're talking about the latest generation Kia Sportage and MG ZS. Watch this.
We have the all-new 2019 Kia Sportage and the 2019 MG ZS. Let's start off by checking out the respective powertrains of our two featured cars. Under the hood of the Sportage is a powerful 2.0-liter common rail direct injection diesel engine that gives up 185 PS of power and 41 kgm of torque. These figures are coupled with a 6-speed automatic transmission with Shiftronic and Shiftlock that transfers all power to two wheels. This layout comes standard across all variants. Meanwhile, the ZS is powered by a 1.5-liter NSE major engine that is capable of producing 114 PS of power and 150 Nm of torque, and is mated to a 4-speed automatic transmission with manual Tiptronic function that sends all power to the front wheels. The thing that makes this layout uncommon is that the engine is naturally aspirated instead of the usual turbocharged. When it comes to these car suspension setups, both the Sportage and the ZS use a McPherson strut at the front. Meanwhile, at the rear, the former is equipped with a multi-link, while the latter uses torsion beam. Both of these setups are pretty basic, although one advantage that the Sportage has over the ZS is that it comes with a high-performance damper for both the front and the rear suspension. Let's proceed to the exterior features of the Sportage and the ZS. One look at the Sportage and you can already tell that it has enough mixture of boldness and ruggedness. He has always said that one of the best-selling points of the Sportage is its exterior design, and it looks like they're not wrong about that. Up front, the car boasts the brand's signature Tiger grille that is further framed by these projector-type LED fog lights. Also over at the rear, an LED combination lamp is present. Additionally, the Sportage gets reshaped bumper corners, adding more character to the subcompact SUV. For the wheels, the top-of-the-line Veyron gets a whopping 19-inch alloy wheels. Other exterior features of the Sportage include a front and rear skid plate exclusively for the GT line, and a rear defogger, as well as a rear spoiler that comes standard in all variants. Overall, the exterior of the Sportage could keep your eyes locked on it for a while. Let's check out the ZS's design and styling. The ZS looks aggressive while maintaining a neat appearance. Like the Sportage, the exterior design of the ZS is one of its strongest features. It being bold and stylish is attributed to the strong character lines that hug and further define its body. On top of that is its front fascia that boasts its signature Stardust grille, as MG dubbed it because of its pattern. The London Eye halogen headlights also add character to the car. At the back end of the ZS, the Polaris taillights take on the spotlight. Meanwhile, on the sides, MG gives an ode to history, as MG's hexagonal badge lends its design philosophy to the ZS's 17-inch alloy wheels. It's now time to take a tour around the interiors of the Sportage and the ZS. Inside the Sportage, everything is wrapped in leather. The seats, the steering wheel, and every other part of the car, including the center console. The seats are comfortable to sit on as well, again, thanks to the premium leather material. The front seats are equipped with slide, recline, with height adjuster configuration, which on the other variants, only the driver gets to enjoy. The rear seats are foldable, so if you need additional space for more cargo, the Sportage offers lots of fit. Moreover, for added convenience, the steering wheel comes in tilt and telescopic adjust configuration, and cruise control is also standard. Also, the air conditioning comes in dual, full auto climate control. On the other hand, the interior of the ZS is one that is simple and straightforward. The dashboard looks modern and is highlighted with circular chrome-trimmed air vents each on both sides. The cabin doesn't look cluttered at all, as the buttons are strategically positioned in one spot altogether. The steering wheel and the seats are wrapped in leather, while you can spot high-quality plastic materials on certain areas. Speaking of the seats, they're comfortable given that they are bucket seats, something that ensures a cozy drive for both the driver and passengers. Moreover, the rear seats seem to be larger and wider compared to other subcompact crossover seats out there. Another highlight of the ZS's interior is a panoramic sunroof that brings pleasant lighting inside the car. Technology-wise, the Sportage comes with a 3.5-inch LCD display. This is available in AM, FM, CD, MP3, AUX-in, and USB port, and is iPod-ready. Sound is enjoyable, courtesy of 6 speakers. Meanwhile, for the ZS, the infotainment system comes in an 8-inch touchscreen display with Apple CarPlay, an obvious advantage for iOS users, with 6 speakers that create a 3D sound effect. When it comes to safety and security, both the Sportage and the ZS are armored with features that ensure nothing less. The Sportage is equipped with dual and side curtain airbag, anti-lock brake system, security alarm immobilizer, and stability control, among others. Meanwhile, the ZS is equipped with features such as reverse camera, anti-lock brake system with electronic brake force distribution, cornering brake control, electronic brake assist, hill start assist, tire pressure monitoring system, and traction control system.
Those are the Kia Sportage and the MG ZS. Two crossovers that are competitively designed to stand out from the crowd. Our featured vehicles here on Head to Head. More about the automobile here in AutoFocus as we usher in our segment featuring the autos of the world, spotlighting concept cars as well as newly launched and about to be launched automobile models from around the world. For your exciting viewing on this edition of your automobile electronic magazine, we have the 2019 Fiat 500 Dolce Vita edition. Let's watch this.
Fiat will be celebrating the anniversary of the 500, the authentic Italian masterpiece that got the people of Europe moving in the 1950s and still continues to amaze today. The new 500 Dolce Vita special edition holds the same values that underlie the most authentic Italian style that is embodied by the Dolce Vita years. As befitting for a timeless beauty, the new sports car, an exclusive Bossa Nova white livery, enhanced by a red and white beauty line drawn around the entire silhouette. Reflecting the elegance of the era, the new 500 has a cursive Dolce Vita chrome badge on the rear that perfectly complements the chrome bonnet line, the chrome door mirror covers, and the body-colored side molding with the 500 logo. The look is completed by elegant 16-inch white alloy wheels and fixed glass roof on the hatchback version. The same refined elegance is applied to the interior of the 500 Dolce Vita with its wooden dashboard and contrasting beauty line. To ensure stability, flexibility, and perfect resistance over time, the wood is applied onto an ultra-light carbon shell. The passenger compartment is the perfect match for the exteriors and is made even more exclusive by new ivory-colored leather seats with embroidered 500 badge, red piping, and a wicker-inspired central panel. The ivory color scheme is mirrored in the floor mats. Available in two configurations, hatchback and convertible, the 500 Dolce Vita Special Edition includes the 69-horsepower 1.2-liter engine with manual transmission. It can also be paired with the optional DualLogic gearbox.
NLEX Viaje Tips presents Healthy Road Trip. It's time for that much-awaited vacation, but here are a few things to watch out for. Sitting for long periods of time can form blood clots in your body, like in the legs. To avoid that, stop for a quick break, get up, and move around to get your blood pumping. Car air conditioners speed up dehydration, so make sure to drink water frequently. Lastly, while driving, protect your eyes from the sun by wearing UV-blocking sunglasses. And for a smoother trip up north, you can now drive all the way to your destination with one RFID. Get your Easy Trip RFID sticker now.
Be it fine dining, a romantic garden wedding, a relaxed casual meal, or an important business event, Ilustrado is the place to go. Aside from its famed paella, the Ilustrado restaurant, which is located within the history-laden walled city of Intramuros, is also the favorite destination of food gourmands for its famous callos and lengua and other classic gustatory offerings. Ilustrado restaurant, only for the foodies.
Welcome back to AutoFocus. Our special feature is next. Honda Cars Philippines recently brought in the Philippine market the latest edition of the well-loved Honda BRV, with a goal to enhance SUV image. In this special feature, we've covered the highlights and happenings of the grand launch of the newest from Honda. Watch this.
Honda Cars Philippines held the grand unveiling of the new BRV at the City of Dreams, Manila, Parañaque City. By bringing in the new BRV to the local market, Honda aims to bring the model closer to Filipino households. With its refreshed exterior and interior designs, the company is positive that the new model will deliver exceptional customer satisfaction and that it will enhance SUV image.
We launched the previous BRV in 2016. And after that, this BRV was very well accepted by Philippine market, especially for family. So then now, we are having a lot of customers to our dealership. We especially enhanced the exterior design and the interior design. Compared to the previous model, our new BRV has very strong, bold design. It is very, very attractive to those who are really want to buy affordable 7-seater SUV.
This model we introduced in 2016 in September during the 6 PIMS. And after our introduction of this model in 2016, we believe that it was acceptable to the market because it's the first affordable 7-seater SUV. So we are here to launch the new refreshed look of the new BRV. What we did was actually to make it more masculine and improve its external feature. How did we do it? By making it more bigger, more active, and more masculine.
Let's take a closer look at the new BRV. The new BRV is powered by the 1.5-liter iVTEC engine that gives out 120 horsepower and 145 Nm of torque. The engine is mated to Honda's Earth Dreams technology continuously variable transmission that delivers a smooth, refined, and fuel-efficient driving performance. Exterior-wise, since the new BRV exudes the grand concept of enhanced SUV image, it now sports a premium look with its sleeker design and advanced features. Up front, the new BRV presents a new chrome front grille that is perfectly paired with a new front bumper for both variants. Included in the updates is its new LED daytime running lights for the 1.5V CVT variant, while maintaining its halogen headlights and fog lights for both variants. Its newly designed 16-inch alloy wheel also contributes to its long, wide stance for a more commanding road presence.
Regarding the exterior changes, we have four changing points. First one is the front grille. Second one is the bumpers. And also third one is grille. And also fourth one is the four upper grilles, LED DRL, and also shark wing antenna. That's total 4 and 5 points changing points.
Inside, the car received exciting updates as well. The 1.5S CVT variant is equipped with a 7-inch capacitive touchscreen display audio, while the 1.5V CVT is equipped with a 7-inch capacitive touchscreen display audio with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto.
The most feature that we could tell about this new model is that it's the most powerful in its class now because of its engine. It's powerful, yet it's fuel efficient.
For added convenience, both variants of the new BRV are now equipped with a reverse camera. The new BRV also maintains a spacious and comfortable cabin that provides ample legroom and head clearance.
The interior changes, we have three changing points. First one is the rear camera is applying to as standard. And also, second one is the audio. We are applying the advanced audio with Apple CarPlay and then Android Auto for upper grades. And also enhancing the decoration, such as the red accents for upper grades. And also, we changed some interior decoration more premium, more active.
The new BRV is now available at all 38 Honda dealerships nationwide.
This product is developed for the Filipino families looking for the affordable 7-seaters. And also our BRV is the applying a powerful engine, but yet very fuel efficient. So if they can use our BRB, more suitable for the daily usage because we have a very fuel efficient powertrain. So they can save the expense, but they can enhance their lives by our product.
We are actually offering two variants for this new model. One is the 1.5 SCBT, which we are offering at 1,035,000 pesos. And the 1.5 DCBT, in which we are offering it at 1,155,000 pesos.
Also during the launching ceremony, Mr. Noriyuki Takakura, President and General Manager of Honda Cars Philippines, during his speech, stressed that the company has faced various challenges since the past year. Nevertheless, they remain positive and continue to serve their Filipino customers.
With the launch of the 2019 Honda BRV and other models from the company, Honda is looking forward to a fruitful rest of the year. That's it for our special feature. We hope you enjoyed. And up next is another exciting features on Autos of the World. This time around, the 2020 Mercedes-Benz AMG CLA 45. Let's watch this.
Outstanding performance, the ultimate in driving dynamic, expressive design, the new Mercedes-AMG compact sports car, the CLA 45, reasserts its leading position in the segment. Seamlessly continuing the success story of Mercedes-AMG's sporty compact cars while setting new standards. The CLA 45 is powered by the newly developed M139 2.0-liter engine, the world's most powerful turbocharged four-cylinder manufactured for series production. With 382 horsepower in the CLA 45, it boasts more power than its predecessor. Fast gear shifts measured in milliseconds and ideal power delivery are guaranteed by the new AMG SpeedShift DCT 8G dual clutch transmission with 8 gears. Active fully variable AMG Performance 4MATIC Plus all-wheel drive distributes the power to the rear axle on a wheel-selective basis using AMG Torque Control for top traction and spectacular drift mode. This is made possible by a new rear axle differential featuring two multi-disc clutches, one for each rear wheel. The 2020 Mercedes-AMG CLA 45 will go on sale in the US by the end of the year. The new Mercedes-AMG CLA 45 is even more distinctive than its predecessors. The exterior conveys sheer driving pleasure, even at standstill. For the first time, the compact class AMG models now also feature the AMG-specific radiator grille with a wide lower contour and 12 vertical louvres as a clear indicator of AMG performance family membership. At the same time, the pronounced shark nose, the slim, deeply contoured headlamps, and the flat, aerodynamically enhanced hood with power domes visually lowers the front section to create the impression of dynamic forward thrust. The wider front fenders with flared wheel arches also accentuate the imposing presence. These create space for the wider front axle and underline the athletic appearance.
The things that make my day. My mini-me. My kind of jam. My passion. My blend of coffee. My inspiration. It's all good with the all-new Vios. My Vios. My drive.
Part of the 2019-2020 Autofocus People's Choice Awards, only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on to www.autofocus.com.ph/AFPCA2019. Then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2019-2020 Autofocus Automobile of the Year in separate standard and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until September 30, 2019.
the Autofocus People's Choice Awards. We'll win. You choose, you decide. Vote now.
Suzuki, all new Eltiga.
Life is beating fast. Find what you're waiting for.
Seven-seater in style. All new Eltiga debut.
Welcome back. We have more cars for you to know and appreciate here in Autofocus as we have our second car review this week. For this car review, taking over the spotlight is the 2019 Mitsubishi Strada, a pickup car that takes pride on its refreshed styling and many more. Find out more about it here. Watch this.
We have here the Mitsubishi Strada GT variant. Under the hood of the latest generation Strada is a 2.4-liter DOHC diesel engine that is capable of producing 181 PS of power and 430 Nm of torque. Our variant here is mated to a 6-speed automatic transmission in place of the old 5-speed. Other variants of the Strada come available in the existing 6-speed manual transmission. The Strada also now features a smarter Super Select 4-wheel drive or Easy Select 4-wheel drive system, which allows the driver to switch the driving mode depending on the roads the car will take on. For the suspension, Mitsubishi did special tuning to the rear suspension of the Strada. It is comprised of an independent double wishbone with coil spring and stabilizers at the front for the 2-wheel drive AT, as well as our variant here, while the rest of the variants use double wishbone with coil spring and stabilizer bar. Meanwhile, for the rear suspension, which has been tweaked, all of the variants feature a rigid elliptic leaf spring with telescopic shock absorbers. This layout not only ensures better handling and ride comfort, but it is also capable of holding more oil because of the dampers. That's enough of the oily bits. Let's proceed to the exterior design of the Strada. With just a glance, it's now noticeable that the newest Strada sports a bolder design compared to its predecessor. It follows Mitsubishi's design concept of rock solid, which embodies the full essence of its engineered beyond tough development key phrase. The front fascia is defined by a high engine hood line and beefier looking lamps. Speaking of the lamps, Mitsubishi tweaked the exterior lights a little as well. The headlamps are side by side with the daytime running lights. Also present in the front bumper are the fog lights and turn signals. Meanwhile, the side and rear views have a newly sculpted body curve with contrasting sharp lines, extended wheel flares, and bright accents. Moreover, the Strada powers through the road with 18-inch alloy wheels. Overall, the exterior look of the newest Strada is one that has the public's interest. Mitsubishi did a good job in making the design of the Strada as one of its best-selling points. Let's hop inside the Strada and check out what the interior offers. It's easy to see that the interior of the Strada mirrors the modern and bold look of its exterior. It's also fitting that it matches the freestyle design outside. Everything is wrapped in premium leather, providing that cozy touch. Also, soft pad materials and stitching can be found on the floor console, armrest, and parking brake. But the real showstopper here is the compartment that serves as a mobile tray, a helpful feature if you need a place to store your mobile phones while traveling. In addition, at the back of the center console, you'll find a similar compartment, complete with new USB ports. More about convenience, the Strada is equipped with an air circulator that absorbs air from the front air vents, then transfers it to the back. Moreover, the infotainment system of the Strada is pretty straightforward. It comes with a touchscreen display system that is available in AM, FM, Bluetooth, and USB connectivity. Sound is enjoyable through 6 speakers. When it comes to safety features, the new Strada is also equipped with advanced technological features such as advanced safety features like forward collision mitigation, blind spot warning with lane assist, rear cross traffic alert, and ultrasonic mist acceleration mitigation system, among others.
That was the 2019 Mitsubishi Strada, proving that it got what it takes to be a pickup car on everybody's list. And that's Autofocus this week. And on behalf of my dad, Butch Gamboa, we hope you have found this edition of your automobile electronic magazine informative as well as entertaining. You can also check us out on our Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram accounts. Until the next time, this has been Ray Louis Gamboa.